Welcome to the presentation on Thompson Highways, the resistors. In this presentation, we shall look into all the characters in this drama. There are 8 characters in this play. The first 2 sisters are Pelagia and Philomena. They are biological sisters. And there are other 3 sisters, Mary Adley, Annie Cook, and Emily Dictionary. These 3 are half-sisters to Pelagia and Philomena. And Veronique is the sister-in-law of all the 5 characters. And she has an adopted daughter, Shabuni Khan. Shabuni Khan is a 24-year-old mentally disabled girl. And there is a special character, Nana Bush. He represents the native spirit. In this character analysis, first of all, we would like to see the character of Nana Bush. The author has a particular purpose for introducing this character. This character is an omnipresent character and plays a remarkable role representing the native spirit. He observes the action throughout the play, of course, invisible to almost 3 or 4 characters. Nana Bush is the Ojibwe name for the trickster. A trickster is the central figure in native mythology. He teaches the natives about the nature and meaning of existence on this earth. In this play, he appears as a seagull, a night hawk, and towards the end of the play, he appears as a male character, that is the bingo master. This character has no fixed gender identity. And through this character, the dramatist also wanted to show that their language, that is in Cree or Ojibwe language also, there is no gender discriminatory words. And he is shown or he is seen by 2 characters in the play. They are Mary Adley and Shabuni Khan. This Nana Bush appears in the scenes of joy, of anguish and despair. And he appears as a seagull, and Mary Adley plays with this seagull. And during the death of Mary Adley, he guides her and he takes her slowly into the world of spirit. And when he appears to this Shabuni Khan, she describes her past and her traumatic experience of sexual abuse to Nana Bush. She hasn't revealed anything to the other characters. And during the climax of the play, Nana Bush appears as bingo master, and in the bingo game, everything seems to be confused, and it reveals the sisters that this is a deceptive game. And bingo is a recurrent reference in this play in order to show the importance given by the native people to material aspect of life. And there also, in the climax also, this Nana Bush appears and it changes the state of Mary Adley from the physical realm to spiritual realm. And he tries to reawaken the audience as well as the other characters. And with this character, the author tries to represent North American Indian mythology. And also, he reminds the core of Indian culture, that is native culture, and makes the characters understand the meaning of existence and also attempts to re-evaluate their recovery of lost voice. The next character is Pelagia. She is the first among the sisters, and she is 53-year-old woman. She dreams of a life away from the reservation because she is dissatisfied by the life in the reserve. Her sons are there in Toronto, and her husband was in Espanola, and her mother was no more. And she works as a contractor, and through this character, Thompson Highway reverses the gender role. And her sister is Philomena, and she is a half-sister to Mary Eardley, Annie, and Emily. And she always feels that she is trapped in the reserve. And she often inspires the other sisters to struggle in the fragmented society. She seems to be the natural leader of the resistors, and she considers herself as a chief. She has a dream in life to build a nice paved road for the reserve, because in the last election, the chief of the reserve promised to build a road, but he failed. And she wanted to raise that education, and she wanted to fulfill that kind of wish of the reserve. And she feels sad about the loss of old stories, old languages, and all those old ways of life. And she wishes the Nana Bush to come back again, but she was not able to see the Nana Bush. Towards the end, when she comes back to the native reserve, she turns back to her work, and during that time, the audience could understand Nana Bush comes again and dances according to the beat of the hammer. And the second character is Philomena Musetter. She is sister of Pelagia. She is 49-year-old, and she used to be the voice of the author. And she is more practical than all the other sisters in the play. She is light-hearted, and she often cracks jokes. And her wish in life is to get a toilet that is big and white and very wide. She is the victim of gender violence. She has a traumatic experience of deserted marriage with a white man. And she gave birth to a child, but she was not allowed to look at the child, and she doesn't even know the gender of the child. And it happened 28 years ago. And she was forcefully separated from the child. And she is the spokesperson of the author, and she teaches that one's place is too much inside one's blood. And the next character, Mary Eardley. She is a silent sufferer because of her cancer, and she has the fear of death. She is a 39-year-old mother figure in the play, and she lives with her husband Eugene and her 14 children. And she hopes to win the bingo money to buy an island island paradise where they can live real nice and comfy life. She dies during the bingo game in Toronto, where her spirit is symbolically transported to the spirit world. She optimistically believes that her husband Eugene would carry the load and care for her children if she passes away. The next character, Annie Cook, is a 36-year-old character, and she is a half-sister of Pelagia and Philomena. He has lost her husband Eugene to her own sister Mary Adley. She is interested in music and she wants to buy a tape recorder and to collect the records of Patsy Cline, a famous singer. Annie hopes to be a country singer, and someday she wanted to marry her boyfriend Fritz, who is a Jewish country musician. She delights in gossiping about the activities of Big Joey, a local man who sleeps with a variety of women. Her daughter Elan lives in a neighboring town with her boyfriend, and she, that is Elan, who informs the mother that the biggest bingo game is going to visit Toronto. The next character is Emily Dictionary. She is also sister of Annie Cook and Mary Adley, 32-year-old woman, and she is a half-sister of Pelagia and Philomena, and she is described as one tough lady in the play. She previously was married to a husband, and he abused her and almost killed her. She used to get beatings from this man. She works in the local store and is also known as a rough ex-biker who lost her lesbian lover in a tragic motorcycle accident in San Francisco. And in the end of the play, she reveals that she is pregnant, and Big Joey, the womanizer, is the father of her child. The next character is Veronique. She is a 45-year-old sister-in-law to all the other women characters. And she complains about her alcoholic husband, who does not care for the adopted daughter, Shabni Khan. This adopted daughter is having mental deficiencies, and this lady, Veronique, is described as busybody and is generally disliked by other characters. After Mary Adley's death, Veronique moves into Star Blanket Home in order to take care of the 14 children and to cook for them. And her aim in life is to get a big stove and to cook for all the children in the reserve. And she also wishes to write a book on cooking. The next character is Shabuni Khan. She is 24-year-old mentally disabled adopted daughter of Veronique. Her parents died in a horrible car crash that happened 24 years ago. And Veronique has raised this girl as her daughter. Only this character, Shabuni Khan, and Mary Adley were able to see Nana Bush in whatever appearance he is presented in this drama. And she reveals her traumatic experience to this Nana Bush. In that experience, she was abused by white boys with a screwdriver, and this girl was not able to realize what had happened to her. And with this presentation, we have learned about all these eight characters, their significances, and their relationship with one another. And we have also learned there's few things, that is the wounded states or wounded situations experienced by some of these characters. In the next presentation, we shall have the thematic analysis of this play. Thank you.